I learned something with the last class. I just want to teach you maybe a word that you're not familiar with. Well, what does simplify mean when I talk about this?
Make the lowest value.
Solve.
Solve is one of my words, my pet peeve words. Nothing in math can be solved except equations, which this is not. Right? So, anyway, that's just a little thing. It's like, things, it doesn't matter all that much. It's one of those things that, to me, solve means something specific. So, simplify just means, well, it looks like you all did it, right? You take numbers, you combine them, and you get them down until you just can't combine them anymore. Right? So, another word that means the same thing is evaluate. Okay, so it's just a word that means the same thing. Simplify just means put all the numbers together as you can, as much as you can, until so you can't anymore. Okay. So, with this expression here that I'm having you simplify or evaluate, what am I trying to test? See what you know? What am I trying to see if you know or you don't know it? Right? Would maybe some people do it differently depending on where you go in the world?
Yeah.
They would do it in a different what?
Different form?
What was different about the form or
like
the way?
Not PEMDAS.
Okay, not PEMDAS. And what is PEMDAS? It's really just an acronym that helps us to remember what? Which is?
Order of operations.
All right, we got it. The order of operations. Are we talking about the correct order of operations? Which one are we talking about?
The one.
The one that we use, that we all agree to use. Okay? And I've done my research, and that one is a very, very popular one. Okay? To review that, PEMDAS. Helpful little acronym. Are those other acronyms are out there, and they try to help you remember those as well. I heard the GMA. Hunter and Mac, this is gonna be over now. I'll be later if you're having trouble. We're gonna go through it right now as well. GMA is another one. GMA is grouping, right? There could be grouping symbols, any number of grouping symbols, parentheses, brackets, or square roots, or whatever. Exponents. Multiplication and division are represented by the N. There's not even a D in there. There's A instead of AS. You can just leave it there.
Right.
Whoever's it is, you're supposed to keep track of it. We don't ever have to worry about their book. So there's different acronyms, but they're trying to get us to remember if they're subgrouped together, do that stuff grouped together, then respect exponents, then respect multiplication and division, and then respect addition and subtraction. So, according to the order that we've agreed to,
yes.
Call it this one. What will we do first before anything else?
Exponents.
We have an exponent on the 4 here, so we'll get
16.
Okay. If we're in another place, in another land, far away, those people might multiply the 3 and the 4 first, and then square 12. Okay. Are we going to do that? No, it'll be out of order, the order that we decided to follow. So we'll carry this 3 through. This is now 16. 3 times 16 is what we're going to move on to. All right. How about on this little stretch? 15 divided by 5 times 3. Should I take the 5 and divide it into 15 or multiply it by the 3?
Divide
it because it's multiply and divide left to right. What's on the left? What operations on the left?
Division.
So we're going to divide 15 by 5 and get 3. So 3 is a number that we're going to multiply by 3. N minus 7. Now we have some multiplication here, some multiplication there, some addition, right? Are we going to add 16 plus 3 and get 19?
No.
No, that's not the order we're going to use. We're going to use this order where we multiply first. Colby?
Yep.
Settle down. Right. 3 times 16, 48, plus 3 times 3 is 9, 7, right? 48 plus 9 is 57, minus 7. Right? If you did not get 50, it's one of two things. You either you went out of order, the order that we agreed to, or you made an actual math error, right? You actually put together two numbers and got the incorrect product or sum or difference or quotient.
I've got it right.
Take a look. If you have any questions, now's a good time to say, I got 16 and I don't know how I got it and I'm not sure.
I got 42, but I know how I got it.
So you can
I multiply first.
Oh, 5 times 3?
Yeah. I messed up at the 4 times 2. I thought it was 4 times 2 instead of 4 times 4. So I got.
That's a common thing to do, to see this as 4 times 2, not 4 times itself twice.
Yeah, I messed up there.
Good. Catching your mistakes, it's better to do it now than tomorrow, because we have tomorrow what?
A test.
The 18th is tomorrow. Right?
What is your test?
To my class, there is a point total, but when they go in the grade book, they all go in as 100. It's just all out of 100%. Okay?
Remember,
this class is a lot different. I don't know why so many teachers don't use weighted grades, but I do. Okay? All your tests go in a big group, and it's worth 55% of your grade. And all your homework is in a big group together, it's all worth 20%. So if one test is worth 50 points and another test is worth 45 points, they go in the gradebook the same. It's a percentage. Okay? It's not a perfect system, but it's the system that I use. Right? So don't pay attention to the point total, it's the percent that goes into the gradebook. Okay? So 44 out of 45, if it happens to be 45 points, well, that would be 98. That's what goes in the book. Right?
Yeah.
Other questions? Whatever. So to prepare for that, we're just going to take the rest of the class and prepare for it. If you are the type of person who likes to look at their notes and study off of those, that's great. If whatever you want to do, you will be spending this time preparing for the test tomorrow. Okay? If you don't have notes or whatever and you're needing something to review, I have a sheet that has review questions on it. Okay, I'm going to give that to everybody. It's not something that you're required to do. You do not have to turn it in tomorrow. It's not worth extra credit if you do it. Okay, so you're going to work on it the whole time. Right? Yeah.
Do we get to use our notebooks on your test or
not? Yes?
Can we look at the videos you can send us? Can we watch them?
During this time? Yeah, that'd be all right. Yes?
While we're studying, can we listen to music?
As long as that's all that's happening with your iPod or phone or whatever it is.
Okay.
Otherwise, where does your phone go?
In
phone jail. Okay. But that shouldn't be a problem. Any other questions? All right, then I'm going to pass all of these out. Work on these if you don't have some other means of studying, right? Whatever you're doing, it's going to be preparation for the test tomorrow. Use the time wisely.